G'day. Welcome to our time together. In Psalm 51, the psalmist reflects on the beauty of God's steadfast love and boundless mercy, acknowledges his own sin, and then cries out in these words, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me." Let's pray. Loving Father God, each day we need your Spirit to be working in us, creating in us a clean heart, putting within us a right spirit, lifting from us the thoughts and the attitudes that keep us separate from you and your ways, and setting in our hearts your love and your light. So, loving God, as we come to worship you, we kneel before you, recognizing the beauty of your embrace. You, the God who calls us and names us your children. Come, Holy God, reveal yourself to us that we might lift your name high. And in gratitude, praise you. In Jesus' holy name, amen. Amen. Let's sing to our God.
God's goodness, Father of all wisdom, come to him and bless his name. Mercy he has shown us, his love is forever, faithful to the end of days.
Come then, all you nations, sing of your Lord's goodness, melodies of praise and thanks to God. Ring out the Lord's glory, praise him with your
story that started it all, from the Lost Sheep series, Cecil. the lost sheep.
Cecil, the lost sheep. What sort of animals does this man have? Rabbits? No, he doesn't have rabbits. Giraffes? Well, he might have giraffes, but they don't get a mention in this story. Sheep? Yes, he has sheep. 100 sheep, including Cecil. One day, Cecil was dreaming. Boring, boring, boring. All I do is hang round with sheep, eat grass, wander down the river for a bit of a drink, and eat more grass. Maybe I could run away and get a bike. Or join a band. Cecil looked left. Cecil looked right. Cecil jumped over the rock and hid. From the rock, he ran behind the tree. And from behind the tree, he ran over the hills to the mountains. Yes, the mountains. He reached the mountains and discovered that they were very high and very steep. But he was not deterred. He climbed higher and higher, and it got steeper and steeper and steeper. He climbed and climbed until he couldn't climb up, and he couldn't climb down. Indeed, Cecil was stuck. He sat on the edge of the ledge and started thinking. I could shout for help. But what happens if the shepherd finds me? He might whack me with his stick. Crack! And then grab me by the leg and drag me home. Bumpity bump bump. Tie me to a tree without any dinner. Now back home, the shepherd was counting his sheep. 1 Terry, 2 Kevin, 3 Bronwyn, 4 Lucinda, 96 Meredith, 97 the other Meredith, 98 Amir, 99 Amelia, 1, 2, 3, 4, 96, 97, 98, 99. Cecil was missing. The shepherd ran to the rock and found the hoof prints leading to the tree. He ran behind the tree and found the hoof prints leading over the hills to the mountains. Yes, the mountains. The mountains were high and steep. The shepherd climbed higher and higher, and it got steeper and steeper. And when he thought he couldn't climb any further, and wasn't sure if he could climb back down, he heard a noise. Bah! Cecil was saved. And what did that shepherd do? Did he whack Cecil with his big stick? Crack! No. Did he grab Cecil by the leg and drag him back down the mountains? Bumpity bump bump bump. No. He was so glad he'd found his lost sheep that he put Cecil on his shoulders and carried him all the way home. And when they got home, did the shepherd tie Cecil to a tree without any dinner? No. Instead, he threw a huge party, and everyone stayed up way past their bedtime. Cecil, the lost sheep, had been found.
The God agenda. To seek the lost and bring them home. Thanks be to God. Let's pray. Oh, loving Father God, we do indeed thank you for your commitment to finding the lost and to bringing us home. We thank you for the love that inspires this, the love that motivates this, the love that gives this agenda of yours energy and purpose. Lord, we recognize that there are so many ways in which we become lost, so many ways in which we become separated, so many ways in which we need you near. And so this day we pray for our world. We pray for all those who feel despair this day, whatever the context, whatever the situation, where hope feels distant, where love feels like it doesn't exist. We pray. We pray an outpouring of your love. We pray an outpouring of your hope. We pray for people who are despairing this day. May your light warm their hearts. Lord, where there is violence, violence between nations, between peoples, violence within communities, within churches, within homes, where there is violence within thoughts, bring your peace. Challenge, we pray, challenge our willingness to choose a path of violence, to achieve our goals, to wrap our desires in the cloak of violence. Break through that, Lord God, with your peace. Lord God, bring your healing and bring your wholeness to the whole of your creation this day, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Let's continue in song.
Come, wounded healer.
reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 15.
Luke chapter 15. Now the tax collectors and sinners were all gathering around to hear Jesus. But the Pharisees and the teachers of the law muttered, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." Then Jesus told them this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And when he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and goes home. Then he calls his friends and neighbors together and says, "Rejoice with me, I found my lost sheep." I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who do not need to repent. Or suppose a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one. Doesn't she light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she finds it, she calls her friends and neighbors together and says, "Rejoice with me, I've found my lost coin." In the same way, I tell you, there is rejoicing in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents.
In the first chapter of 1 Timothy, Paul writes, "I am grateful to Christ Jesus, our Lord, who has strengthened me because he judged me faithful and appointed me to his service. Even though I was formerly a blasphemer, a persecutor, and a man of violence, but I received mercy because I had acted ignorantly in unbelief, and the grace of our Lord Jesus overflowed for me with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am foremost." Paul understood the agenda of God as revealed in Jesus, an agenda that was salvation, mercy, rescue and redemption, an agenda that is life through love. Paul got it. Paul got it because he had lived it. He had been lost in his self-righteousness and his religiosity. He had been lost in his pursuit of what he thought was religiously important. He'd been lost in the structures of the institution of the Jewish faith. And then he discovered the grace and the mercy of God, the one who has an agenda for coming to all of us in our places of lostness and saying, "Come, be found." Jesus shows us the reality in the words that we have heard, an agenda for finding and returning, retrieving the lost. We have the story of the lost sheep. The shepherd who leaves the 99 to find the one. Who's not satisfied that almost 100% are there. Who has the level of commitment to finding that one. We hear the story of the woman and the lost coin. The commitment to finding and retrieving the lost. And the passage that follows this, that often is referred to as the story of the prodigal, which means the returning, or the lost son. Here's the thing. There are two lost sons in this story. One is lost in the pursuit of pleasure and self. The other is lost in his dedication to what was expected and was right. But neither understood or embodied the heart of their father. They were both lost in two very different places. And the Father for each of them comes to them in their lostness and says, come, be found. Come, return to the heart of what's going on. This is the good news. This is the agenda of God. To come into a world that God created with such beauty and potential, but that has experienced such heartache. And that so many of us have moments and spaces in which we are lost. This God comes and says, I'm looking for you. I want to show you the way to life. And life in the full, life eternal. I want to show you love. The kind of love that grows life. The kind of love that creates space for others to find love. The kind of love that is sacrificial. That is willingness to forgo its own that others might be blessed. This is the agenda of God. To find the lost. And it's good news. It is good news if we are lost. It is good news if our loved ones are lost. If there are people in our circles and our networks that we think are lost, that are struggling, that are hurting, we can go, hey God, thank you for this agenda. Thank you for your commitment to finding and retrieving the lost. This is good news. And if all you want today is a warm, fuzzy service, switch off now, because there's a hard word. And the hard word is this. If we are fair dinkum about our Christianity, if we are fair dinkum about being disciples of Jesus, if we are serious about living the faith, then we need to embody the agenda of God. The agenda to find, to seek, and to retrieve the lost. And it might have to start with us. To recognize what we are lost in. Are we lost in our traditions? Are we lost in our desires for comfort? Are we lost in our desires to have the gospel shaped in our own image? Are we lost in our worries and concerns? Are we lost in our image and how we look in our community? Are we lost in nostalgia? Are we lost in the confusion of how we keep up with a rapidly changing world? Maybe the hard word for us is actually, as it was for Paul, to recognize that with all the passion, with all the conviction, and with all the understanding that we have, we are actually lost in our religion. Maybe that's the hard word. The good news is, that's okay. God is there, calling, challenging, comforting, and providing us a way home. But if, as Jesus says, the healthy don't need a doctor, and we are not lost, we have discovered the Lord Jesus Christ, and we've got a reasonable handle on what that means, then the hard word remains for us to be living the agenda of God to find and retrieve the lost. And so what are we doing? What are we seriously doing about coming to our neighbours, to our community and to the world with the good news of Jesus? And if the best we can do is say, oh, we've got a nice church and it's open for an hour once a week, then friends, we need to be on our knees like the psalmist, crying out for the mercy of God, crying out for a clean heart, a right spirit within us, crying out, as the psalmist writes, for wisdom. Because a gathering in a building for an hour once a week is nowhere near the level of commitment that Jesus demonstrates. It might be a useful part of what we do. It might be a wonderful expression of community. It might be a wonderful way of showing people what it means to read the scriptures, pray together, sing together, worship God. But it's not the be-all and end-all. This is not the be-all and end-all. This is but a snack on the journey of faith. The God agenda is to find the lost and bring them home. The call to each and every person of faith is to get on board with what God is doing. In your context, in my context, in our contexts. And that will be different for different ones of us. What does it really look like to go, to get down on our hands and knees like the woman and search for that lost coin, to leave the 99 and to go and find the one, to be on the highways and byways looking for the sun, to be willing to step out of the party and speak with the one who is angry and annoyed? Hear the good news. God has an agenda for the lost. A desire from God's love that those of us who are distant, caught up, disconnected, be found and brought to the heart of God's embrace. That is the good news. The hard word is that we need to value what God values. We need to value this. That at the heart of God is an agenda for finding and retrieving the lost. An agenda which God underlines in the death of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Loving Father God, it is good news that whenever we get ourselves lost, whenever we wander down weird roads, whenever we choose poor paths, you are there, seeking us, calling out to us, loving us. Help us this day to make your passion ours, that all people might hear joy and gladness, that all people might know the life that flows from your divine love. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing.
Took a walk outside of my walking, stepped inside another's shoes. Walked the dusty borders between us, paths I'd never chosen to choose. How then shall I live?
How then shall I live? How then shall I live, O God? How then shall I live?
Heard a sound outside of my listening. Felt the living hum of the ground. Waited on the voice of the Spirit, singing with its new old sound.
How then shall I live? How then shall I live? How then shall I live, O God? How then shall I live?
Saw the world outside of my looking. Gazed upon the eyes of its soul. Held the hopes and fears of tomorrow. Found the pieces making the whole.
How then shall I live? How then shall I live? How then shall I live, O God? How then shall I live?
Took a step outside of my walking. Found within a beat that we share. Walked with you the length of a lifetime. And made of life a living prayer.
How then shall I live? 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 How then shall I live, O God? How then shall I live?
To go this day. Spend a moment asking the Spirit of God to show you the spaces in your life in which you are caught up and lost and distant from God. And allow God to call you back from there. And go. Go to your neighbors, to the ends of the earth, with the good news of God's love. To the glory of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Like a candle burning wildly, raging soft against the night, spark that leaps to clear the shadow. Stand strong against all pain, for it's only in the burning that the candle shows its flame. Like a river running freely, rapid swirl beside our feet, swiftly flowing from the highland, comes to rest still waters meet. King turns we least expect. When the Spirit churns within us, know God's power through the test. Like an angel walking lightly on this fragile earth of clay, touching folk with raw compassion, laughing, playing on. Show compassion strong and kind. Bind the hurt.